know that the global impact of injury and road traffic crashes is more than HIV, TB, malaria combined. Did you know that? No one knows that. And yet that's the case.
Yeah, I was privileged to be at UCSF Orthopedic Surgery Residency at a time when IGOT was still an idea that was being thrown around at the pub after a long day of residency and operating and taking care of patients.
Over drinks on a typical Thursday afternoon in San Francisco's Mission District, an idea was born. What if a handful of dedicated surgeons, residents, and administrators could apply their skills to impact this major global health problem? This is where the Institute for Global Orthopaedics and Traumatology, or IGOT, was born.
The challenge in creating something novel is significant. No other orthopedic program had done anything like this before.
We would go and talk, Dr. Coughlin, Dr. Goslin, Jurgensen, a lot of the founding members who were my teachers when I was a resident, had this, you know, this wild idea that we could, as orthopedic surgeons, really affect change in the way that orthopedic patients are taken care of globally.
We really wanted to do something on a grander scale, something that made a greater difference in our approach to this enormous problem. And that is the creation of the Institute for Global Orthopaedics and Traumatology.
At the outset, a small but talented group of surgeons and residents took the first steps toward making IGOT's mission a reality.
We started a teaching, learning activity called the SMART Course, Surgical Management and Reconstructive Training, in 2009.
Yeah, it wasn't, we hadn't even come up with a catchy name for it at that point. And it was my first year on faculty. And yeah, I mean, it was a wonderful experience.
What we try to teach here are simple techniques to manage these wounds and salvage limbs, which most of the time so far are treated with amputation.
So we have been doing this in San Francisco for a number of years, where we have 50 or 60 participants coming from all over the world. So global surgeons coming to San Francisco, learning with us in a cadaver-based course.
In 2013, IGOT took the course on the road, holding their first training away from UCSF in Dar es Salaam, Tanzania.
We strongly believe in the academic-to-academic partnering as a most effective, sustainable way of knowledge exchange and mitigating this enormous disparity that exists in our world.
And that was the foundation of IGOT. That was IGOT's aha moment, in that we really didn't need to just go somewhere and do some work and then leave. We wanted to develop partnerships. IGOT's biggest word for me is really sustainability, and it does so through these tremendous collaborative partnerships.
The value of this course is very high. After this course, I'm confident to manage patients with soft tissue loss, spine loss, with infection, with open fractures. So the course is very useful. That's why we ask IGOT to have this similar course to be conducted in Tanzania, and which we have been doing now for 3 years.
From the very beginning, residents were at the core of IGOT's educational approach, and through its first 15 years, over 100 residents have taken part in this unique endeavor.
We came up with the concept of this being a wonderful opportunity for our residents to get greater experience. What we discovered was, when you expose young learners, young trainees to this kind of activity, the light bulb goes off for them about using their skills to a greater good.
I developed an interest in global health, and I had an interest in orthopedics, and I didn't know how to put them together. And I was lucky enough to connect with Rick Coughlin when I was a medical student, actually. He is the one who kind of inspired me through IGOT to pursue this as part of my career.
Over the years, the SMART course has grown to include an orthotics and prosthetics component, teaching state-of-the-art techniques to improve the lives of those who have already suffered limb loss.
So it's exciting for me to be involved with a course like this because, you know, a lot of the surgical techniques are about saving limbs, limb salvage techniques, but I'm here to assist or aid in the situation where there is limb loss.
In recent years, IGOT's work has caught the attention of media outlets and medical organizations. IGOT founding members Richard Coughlin and Richard Goslin have been recognized for their achievements in and contributions toward the discipline of orthopedics. Both have been presented with the AAOS Humanitarian Award. And in 2020, Dr. Goslin became the first doctor to represent orthopedics in the Red Cross. And through IGOT's mentorship, we have seen many academic partners become OTA Humanitarian Award recipients. Today, IGOT has grown its reach to countries around the globe, both through the in-person SMART course model and online through the IGOT portal.
We've learned new ways to teach, and so, for example, we're really trying to push our online educational programs, the IGOT portal. We're running webinars.
We are reaching more surgeons throughout the world. We have created highest of standard educational material. Our content developers are top-notch surgeons.
Looking forward, IGOT is working to expand its mission to other orthopedic subspecialties, such as pediatric orthopedics.
Musculoskeletal disease profoundly impacts, you know, children around the world, both due to trauma and congenital deformities and other musculoskeletal problems. Severely impact kids and can impact their entire working life, so it's a priority for us to be able to address that unmet need. And so we've expanded our leadership to include pediatric orthopedic surgeons. We've got a whole initiative focused on pediatric orthopedic education and very excited for what our future is in terms of addressing musculoskeletal problems in children.
We need your help. We need support as we move forward with our expansive online portfolio. We're going to need the administrative support to really drive our ability to find content generators and to produce the most highly productive, highest standard academic material.
We can't do what we do at IGOT without the generous support of foundations and private donors. Sustaining our efforts really, really relies on the generous support of donors like you.
This is a tremendous use of your hard-earned dollars that we are able to take almost all of what you donate to dedicate to a tremendously important cause and something that is going to last beyond your contribution and will have long-term effects on generations to come.
They think they give us a very small knowledge, but that knowledge is so precious to us because it gives us power to do more big things, to help and to help ourselves.